John Paul II taught that each man was nailed to the cross. Man, discovering through faith the redemptive suffering of Christ, also discovers in it his own sufferings. The sufferings of our Lord Jesus Christ were not your sufferings, and they were not mine. To speak, therefore, as John Paul II does, is to say that man is Jesus Christ. When we look at the cross, we see in it the passion of man, the agony of Christ. Even though St. Paul reminds us that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again, death no longer has dominion over him, Romans 6:9. Death still continues to be a part of human existence. Christ continues to die. Christ continues his agony in so many of our brothers and sisters, in so many Christians and Muslims, in believers and non-believers. John Paul II begins by admitting that Christ will never die again, Romans 6, verse 9. He then tells us that death continues to be a part of human existence. He then proceeds to tell us that Christ continues to die in Muslims and Christians, in believers and non-believers. His train of thought is not difficult to follow. Though Christ will never die again, man still dies, thus Christ dies because man is Christ. Furthermore, the fact that he stresses that Christ dies even in Muslims and non-believers definitely indicates that he holds that every man is Jesus Christ. As we contemplate Christ dead on the cross, I think of the places where man is insulted. In every person's suffering, Christ continues to suffer and die. On the faces of those who have been defeated by life, there appear the features of the face of Christ dying on the cross. As we contemplate Christ dead on the cross, we don't think of the places where man is insulted and humiliated, because man is not Jesus Christ. Man is endowed with immense dignity when violence is done to him by unlawful restraint, a criminal and most grave offense is committed against God. At that moment, Christ retraces the steps of his passion and suffers the horrors of the crucifixion. John Paul II speaks in quite graphic terms about how Christ retraces the steps of his passion and again suffers the horrors of the crucifixion wherever man is offended, for he holds that man is Jesus Christ. He also says that whenever man is offended, a mortal sin is committed against God, quote, a most grave and criminal offense. He, Emmanuel, God with us, was crucified in the concentration camps and the gulags. He knew affliction under bombardment in the trenches. He suffered wherever the inalienable dignity of man, of every human being, was humiliated, oppressed, and violated. Our Lord Jesus Christ is Emmanuel, Isaiah 7, verse 14, Matthew 1, verse 23. And our Lord Jesus Christ was crucified once for our sins. Emmanuel was not crucified in the concentration camps and the gulags, because each man is not the crucified Jesus. By using such a specific term, John Paul II is teaching that every man is Jesus Christ. What is man? This question of the psalmist rings with an astonishment still more profound before the mystery that reaches its climax on Golgotha. What is man? What is man? What is man? Golgotha is the Aramaic name for Mount Calvary, the place where our Lord Jesus Christ was crucified. John Paul II states that the mystery of man reaches its culmination or climax on Golgotha, Calvary. But the life of Jesus Christ reached its culmination on Calvary. This is a clear indication that in his diabolical view, every man is Jesus Christ. The lesson of the cross is the power of God. It is the summit of the good news. It leads to the fullness of the truth about God and about man. Since there came once and for all the hour of Christ, the Lamb of God, the hour of his departing from this world to the Father, that hour lasts and fills all the hours up to the end of the world. Man, who bears the whole visible world in himself, this man bears the world in himself. John Paul II tells us that Christ departs to the Father in every hour till the end of time. He also mentions that man bears the whole world in himself. This demonstrates again that he teaches that every man is Jesus Christ. Evangelium Vitae 50.2, quote, "But the glory of the cross is not overcome by this darkness. Rather, it shines forth ever more radiantly and brightly and is revealed as the center, meaning, and goal of all history and of every human life. The glory of the cross is revealed as the meaning of every human life, John Paul II says. Keep this in mind as we read the next quote from Evangelium Vitae, which appears in the paragraph immediately following this one. Evangelium Vitae 50.3, quote, "The Son of God is revealed for who He is. On the cross His glory is made manifest. By the glory of the cross, the Son of God is revealed," according to John Paul II. "The glory of the cross is also the meaning of every human life," according to John Paul II, as he told us in Evangelium Vitae 50.2. The only conclusion to be drawn from this is that the Son of God is the meaning of every human life. The glory of the cross is the meaning of every human life, Evangelium Vitae 50.2. The glory of the cross reveals the Son of God, Evangelium Vitae 50.3. Conclusion: the Son of God is the meaning of every human life.